Hello, everybody. Here we are, almost live with the 2009 College Football Preview Show. And hopefully this show will last longer than the Chevy Chase Show and the Magic Hour, which I think those shows lasted like 3 days? Something like that. Anyway, throughout the season, we'll be previewing the Oklahoma Sooners and their upcoming matchups and have post-game. But since the Sooners don't play for another week, we thought we would take this opportunity to highlight college football in general. Our second episode will preview the Big 12, and then the third episode will be our 2009 Oklahoma Sooner preview. Let's not waste any time. Let's go ahead and preview college football in general. We'll begin in the SEC, the best conference since the BCS was incepted back in 1998. Four national champions have come from that conference, including last year's conference champion, the Florida Gators, who returned loaded, and they also returned Tim Tebow, the Heisman winner from 2 years ago. He also finished third in last year's Heisman. Never seen him play before. He's a pretty big, bulky guy. Looks like a fullback. And also plays like a fullback. He loves to hit, he loves to talk trash, and he's hard to bring down. And he does a decent job of throwing the ball as well. He does, however, lose Lewis Murphy and Percy Harvin. Both are gone to the NFL. So who will he throw to? Well, he'll have new targets to throw to and a tight end named Aaron Hernandez, who played some last year. He'll probably be Tebow's early favorite target. Now, as far as the defense, no need to worry about replacing anybody there. Except one player, because they returned 10 starters. That's right, 10 come back for Florida, including the best player on defense, in my opinion, in the nation. That's Brandon Spikes at linebacker. Other than LSU on the road, Florida's schedule looks pretty easy. They'll be big favorites in every game they play except the game at LSU. I think they win the East, and I think they beat Alabama in the SEC championship game. Bama, coming out of the West, has the best defense. They'll have to replace their quarterback. John Parker Wilson's graduated, but the quarterback was not a spot that they really relied on last year anyway. It was the defense that carried them. I think the defense will get them back to the SEC title game, but they'll fall short against Florida. Ole Miss, I'm not sold on their defense yet, and LSU's defense was terrible last year, and they had issues at quarterback. Let's move now to the Pac-10 and USC. They've won that conference the last 7 years. Their offensive line is intact. It will be a good one. Now, as far as the quarterback, it looks like they're going to go with a true freshman named Matt Bradley. When you're behind that offensive line, shouldn't have to worry too much. Should get plenty of time to throw the ball, and he should fit right into that USC offense, despite the fact that at this time last year, he was a high school senior. Now, USC's schedule, though, too tough. Playing at Ohio State, a game that they better watch out, at Notre Dame, and then at California and at Oregon. Yuck, 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 yuck. They can't get through that gauntlet of games unbeaten. There's no way. Now, California, they return a very explosive running back in the form of Jared Best. Best, very quick, very fast, and he's back for the Bears. But Cal and Oregon's defense gave up too much last year, especially Oregon. They gave up at least 28 points a game in 5 games. That can't get the job done if that trend continues. We'll find out how good Oregon is when they play at Boise State in early September. And Oregon does return Jeremiah Masoli, a quarterback who can hurt you with his arm and with his legs. But again, the question for Oregon will be their defense. We'll see if that improves. The Big Ten now, only two names you need to know. Everybody else is irrelevant. Ohio State and Penn State. The Nittany Lions, I think their schedule is easy. Non-conference schedule is Akron, Syracuse, and Temple. Who scheduled that schedule? The Domino's Pizza Delivery guy? I mean, come on. And then the Big Ten schedule, they get Ohio State, the other top-notch Big Ten team, at home. How great's that? I don't think they're one of the best teams in the country, but I think Penn State, because of that schedule and because they get Ohio State at home, I think they go unbeaten, and I think they pass all the teams ahead of them, because the teams ahead of them, other than Florida, I think will lose. So Penn State, I think, will be number 2 in the BCS when it's all said and done, and they'll play Florida for the national championship. I hate to say that, but I have to be realistic. I think Florida plays Penn State in the BCS title game because of Penn State's schedule and just because Florida is that much better than everybody else. No further explanation needed, and I think Florida wins the whole thing. But hey, for kicks and giggles, let's go ahead and preview Ohio State and Terrell Pryor. He's back at quarterback for the Buckeyes. Very athletic quarterback, but had trouble throwing the ball last year. He has worked extensively on his passing game during the offseason. We'll see if that pays off. Big questions for Ohio State will be at receiver and especially at running back, where they lose Beanie and Vernon Wells. But they do have Dan Heron, who is a fastback. but doesn't carry quite the breakaway capability as far as breaking the tackles, not quite as big as the Wells. So we will see if Ohio State can fine-tune the running game, which was such a big factor in their success a year ago. Then we look at the ACC, Virginia Tech. They won this conference 2 years in a row. They should win it again because of their defense and because they have the world on their side. That's Jason Worlds, an All-American defensive end. However, a big loss for Vautech, I think, will keep them from getting to the national championship game, and that is the loss of their running back in Darren Evans. Gained over 1,200 yards a year ago for the Hokies, but he had a knee injury, I guess, in the early part of a summer camp or 2 days. So now Evans is gone, so you have a big void there in the backfield. But again, the Hokies are experienced at defense and their special teams. You know, with Frank Beamer as head coach, they generally create great field position and sometimes touchdowns. That's what Frank Beamer teams do. Two sleepers in the ACC you better watch out for: North Carolina. They are starting to get the real good players. Butch Davis, their head coach, he has that impact. Remember, he's a former NFL coach as well and coached under Jimmy Johnson at the Dallas Cowboys. Davis is getting the real good players. They're already ranked in the top 20, so you better watch out for North Carolina, and you know that North Carolina will bring the D. And Georgia Tech, they have plenty of offense. They have a triple option attack, and they also feature, in my opinion, the best running back in the country in Jonathan Dwyer. You're going to see this guy play on Sundays in the NFL next decade, guaranteed, barring an injury. But Vautech, I think, comes out of the ACC. Their defense is just too good. And then the Big East Conference is a joke. No team right now is ranked in the top 25 coming out of that conference. I'll take Rutgers. They're going to be my team to win this conference just because somebody has to win it, and I like their schedule. They get the contenders of the Big East, if you want to call them contenders, Vautech and Cincinnati. Both teams lost heavily, a lot of seniors. Pittsburgh has no offense, and South Florida, they haven't been quite the South Florida that we've seen 2 years ago. They get all four of those teams, Rutgers do, at home. Big benefit there. And then finally, we look at Notre Dame, the Fighting Irish. That's an easy schedule. Other than USC at home, Notre Dame virtually plays nobody. Washington, Washington State, Nevada, Navy, Boston College, Stanford, Purdue. Are you kidding me? You can't win at least 9 games from that schedule. Charlie Weiss, you do deserve to lose your job. But we'll see what happens with Notre Dame. Remember, if they can finish in the top 8 in the BCS standings, then they'll get a BCS bid, which I think is a joke because other than USC, they play a cream puff schedule. Some BCS busters to look at, maybe teams that aren't from BCS conferences that could get to a BCS game. I think Boise State has the best shot because they're going to play a marquee team early in the season at home in Oregon. So we'll see on that Blue Smurf field if Boise State can pull off the victory and move their ranking even higher. Nobody in the Western Athletic Conference is going to come close to challenging them. And then the Mountain West Conference, you have TCU, you have BYU, and you have Utah. I think BYU will win that conference. They get TCU at home, and they get Utah at home. Two teams they had to play on the road last year and two teams they lost to. I think they get revenge on them. But BYU will not be a factor nationally because of the fact that they have to play Oklahoma and they have to play at home against Florida State. I think they lose both those games. But Max Hall is a terrific quarterback. He should be the conference's player of the year. TCU plays at Clemson. They might be able to win that game because Clemson, they were a disappointment last year. I don't think they're all the way back just yet. But TCU, I don't think, can win at BYU. And Utah, they were the last year's Cinderella darlings, finished second in the country and undefeated, but they lost their quarterback. They lost too many players on offense to ask them to go undefeated again. Probably win 9 or 10 games, but no more than that. So that does it for your college football preview show. Remember, we'll have the Big 12 preview show coming up on our next edition. Until next time, may the sports be with you. And I just-